So today we have another surprise guest today. And we have a couple of show and tells. Yes, I see our musicians are ready. welcome to all of you. So I will begin with some pranati. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shimate Bhaktivedanta Swamin Dinamine Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vancha Kalpa Drubyascha Kripa Sindubya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Nama. Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dinabando Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gorangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Rishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. I have a couple of other prayers here. One for Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. Vishvasyanata Rupo Saum Bhakti Vartma Pradarshanat Bhakta Chakre Vartitatvat Chakravartyakyaya Chakravartyakyaya Ye Bhavet. Whoops, that must be a mistake. Chakravartyakyaya Ye Bhavet. Okay. Because he has shown the residents of this universe, Vishvavasis, the path of bhakti, he is called Vishvanatha. And because he is situated amongst the circle, chakra, of devotees, he is called Chakravarti. And this was written by Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And we also have for Srila Narottam Das Thakur, Shri Krishna Namam Ritavarshi Vaktra Chandra Prabhadvasta Tamobaraya Gauranga Devanucharaya Tasmai Namo Nama Srila Narottamaya. I offer respectful obeisance to Srila Narottam Das Thakur, a sincere follower of Lord Gauranga Deva. The nectarian shower of the holy name radiating from the moon of his mouth destroys the darkness of ignorance. Yeah. So we can sing our Sharanagati song of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. This is a well-known song. It was included, as far as I remember, sort of in the very beginning of songbook creation in ISKCON. I think probably the earliest songbook had this song. Shuddha Bhakata Charana Renu. So it's interesting to sing this knowing the context that it's part of the Sharanagati in general, and more specifically, it's part of Bhakti Anukul Matrakaryar Svikar. It's song number 3. So it's describing activities that are favorable, anukula, for devotional service. Let's read the translation first. The dust of the lotus feet of pure devotees, enthusiastic devotional service, and service to the pure devotees of the highest order are the roots of the creeper of devotion. The holy days like Ekadashi and Janmashtami are the mother of devotion for those devotees who respect them. Let the holy places of Krishna's pastimes be my places of worship and bless me. May I always visit all the holy places associated with the Leela of Lord Chaitanya and his devotees. When I hear the sound of the mridanga in my heart, I always desire to join in kirtan. And when I hear the bona fide songs describing Lord Chaitanya's pastimes, my heart dances in ecstasy. Whenever I see the transcendental Sri Vigrahas of Radha Krishna, I am in bliss. For by taking their lordship's prasad, we can conquer over the material elements. One day, while performing devotional practices, I saw my house transformed into Goloka Vrindavan. When I take the Charanamrita of the deity, I see the holy Ganges waters that come from the feet of Lord Vishnu, and my bliss knows no bounds. By seeing the Tulsi tree, my heart feels joy, and Lord Madhava, Krishna, is also satisfied. When I eat the prasad favored by Lord Chaitanya, it is a new life's experience. And in parentheses is written, Lord Chaitanya was very fond of a green vegetable preparation called shak. And there is another song in this book that tells of the amazing effects of this type of prasad. And the last verse, Bhaktivinod concludes by saying, whosoever attains the stage of enthusiasm for these devotional practices will be supremely blissful wherever he may be. So it's a very happy song. Shuddha Vakata Chana Renu Bhajana Anukula Shuddha Vakata Charana Renu Bhajana Anukula Bhakata Se Paramasiddhi Premalatikara Mule Bhakata Se Paramasiddhi Premalatikara Mula Madhava Titi Bhakti Janani Jetane Palana Kordi Madhava Titi Bhakti Janani Jetane Palana Kordi Krishna Bosati Bosati Boli Parama Adare Bori Krishna Bosati Bosati Boli Parama Adare Bori Gora Amar Jeshavastane Korala Ramana Range Gora Amar Jeshavastane Korala Ramana Range Jeshavastane Haribo Ami Pranayi Bhakata Sange Se Sabastan Haribo Ami Pranayi Bhakata Sange Mridanga Bhajya Sunite Ma Avasara Sada Jache Mridanga Vadya Sunite Ma Avasara Sada Jache Gora Vihita Kirtana Suni Anande Hridaya Nache Gora Vihita Kirtana Suni Anande Hridaya Nache Jugala Murti Dakhiya Mora Parama Ananda Hoya Jugala Murti Dakhiya Mora Parama Ananda Hoya Prasada Seva Korite Hoya Sakala Prapancha Jaya Pasana Seva Korite Hoya Sakala Prapancha Jaya Jedina Grihe Vajana Deki Krihete Goloka Vaya Jedina Grihe Vajana Deki Krihete Goloka Vaya Charana Situ Dakiya Ganga Sukasa Sima Haya Charan Asidhu Dakiya Ganga Sukana Sima Haya Tulasi Daki Judaya Pran Madhava Toshani Jani Tulasi Deki Judaya Pran Madhava Toshani Jani Gora Priya Shakta Sevane Jivana Sartaka Mani Gora Priya Shakta Sevane Jivana Sartaka Mani Bhakti Vino Krishna Bhajane Anukula Paya Bhakti Vinod Krishna Bhajane Anukulapaya Jaha Prati Divase Paramasuke Sikara Koraye Taha Bhakat Prati Divase Paramasuke Sikara Koraye Dasa Shudha Bhakata Charana Venu Apajana Anu Pula Shudha Bhakata Charana Venu Bhajana Anu Pula Bhakata Seva Paramasiddhi Premalati Kara Mohula Bhakata Seva Paramasiddhi Premalati Kara Mohula Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Hari Bo Hari Bo Hari Bo Go Hari Bo Jai Go Hari Bo Hari Bo, Hari Bo, Hari Bo. So again, the translation with the Bangla, briefly. Shudha Bhakata Charanarenu Bhajana Anukula. The dust of the lotus feet of pure devotee, of course, Shudha Bhakata, Bhakta, Charanarenu. The word charana is kind of a respectful way to refer to feet. Literally goers, and renu means dust. Bhajana anukula. So we have this word that's the theme of all of these, this group of songs, anukula. Here, bhajana anukula, favorable for bhajana, for engagement in bhakti practice. Bhakata Seva Paramasiddhi, the highest perfection, Paramasiddhi, is Bhakta Seva, service to the devotees, which is the root, the mula of the Prema Lati, Latikar. Lata is a creeper, Latikar. Also creeper, maker of a prema lata. Madhava Titi, the days, associated with Madhava are Bhakti Janani, are mothers of Bhakti, Jatane, Palanakuri, I protect them literally. Let's see. or respect them. Palanak mean respect. Krishna vasati vasati boli. Boliya. Parama adare bori. Let the holy places of Krishna's pastimes be my places of worship and bless me. So bosati is vasati in Sanskrit. The places where Krishna resides. Let them be my places of worship. Then Gora Amar Jeshabstane Koralo Brahmana Ronge. Brahmana, it's different from Brahmana. This is Brahmana, means wandering. So Koralo Brahmana, doing the wandering. Gora Stane, Jeshabstane, all those places. Associated with Gora, Amar Gora, my Gora, Range, in great happiness, joy, wandering, Sheshab. So we have Jeshab and then Sheshab. This is relative, correlative. Those places where, in the first line, and then Sheshab, those places. All those places, Sheshabstan, Haribo Ami, I will see. Haribo is future tense. Pranayi Bakata Shange, together with the dear devotees in the Sangha, in the association of dear devotees. Ridangabadya Shunite Mon, Abhashara Shadajache. When I hear the sound of the mridanga in my heart, he's translated mon as heart instead of mind, which is nice. The vadya, the sound of mridanga, shunite, hearing. I always desire to join the kirtan. Avasar, I believe, means opportunity. Sugopi Mataji. Sugopi can tell us.
Which one, Maharaj?
Abhasar.
Abhasar is opportunity.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Thank you. Abhasar Sada Jache. That opportunity, I want to go to that opportunity. Gaur Bihita Kirtan Shuni Shunya Anande Hridoya Nache, dancing blissfully in the heart. Let's see. I hear the bona fide songs describing Mahaprabhu's pastimes. My heart dances in ecstasy. Gaur Bihita. So Bihita is like established, bona fide. Hearing the bona fide, which means not hearing the not bona fide, kirtan. My heart dances in joy. Jugala Murti, Dakya Mor, Parama Ananda Hoy. Whenever I see the transcendental Shivigrahas of Radha Krishna, Jugala, of course, means two together. Jugala Murti is also a particular way that Radha and Krishna are represented as embracing each other. Whenever I see the Shivigrahas of Radha and Krishna, I'm in bliss, for by taking their lordship's prasad, we can conquer over material elements. Prasad seva korite hoy shakal prapancha joy. Prapancha means the material world. And I believe it's derived from the word pancha, which means five. So the pancha mahabhutas, the five main elements. I should move. Sorry, what was that? I just got a message from move the mobile phone a bit away from the microphone. Okay. I'll move it further away. Okay, I hope that's better.
Yeah, it's okay, Guru Maharaj, now it's okay.
Okay, sorry. Where are we? Prasad seva korite hoy sakal prapancha. Yes, the word prapancha. So produced of the five, we might say. Jaya, victory, success over material world. Jedina grihe. So now comes his vision. One day while performing devotional practices, I saw my house transformed into Goloka Vrindavan. Have any of you had this experience of your house becoming transformed into Goloka Vrindavan? Maybe sometimes. Your house or your car? I see some of you are in your cars. yes, okay. Jedina grihe vajana deki. That would be deki, I think. Grihete goloka bhai. My griha became goloka. Charana sidu dakiya ganga. Sukas, here it says in this version, sa sima pai. I believe that's a mistake. I think it should be na sima pai. Sukha na sima pai. My happiness had no limit. Sima means limit. Paya to gain. Na sima pai. It gained, it experienced no limit. seeing the holy Ganges waters that come from the feet of Lord Vishnu, Charana Sidhu, from the liquor of the feet of the Lord. Tulasi Deki Jurai Pran Madhava Toshani Jani. By seeing the Tulsi tree, my heart feels joy, and Lord Madhava, Krishna, is always satisfied. Madhava Toshani, Janiya, seeing, knowing, I believe. Jurai Pran. Jurai Pran, Jurai, I don't know. Gora Priya, Shak Sevane Jivan Sartak Mani. So, Shak, as we read in the translation, well, as I understand, in Bengal, any green leafy vegetable is called Shak. And Prabhupada mentions in a purport, there are 25 different types of shak in Bengal. There's probably even more than that, but maybe there's 25 popular ones. So shak sevani, doing the service of shak, doing spinach service. See, only in Krishna consciousness can you do spinach service. Gora Priya, which is very dear to Lord Gauranga. Jivan Sartak Mani. Sartak means fulfillment of Artha. Sa Artha So it means success. The success of life is gained. So all you have to do to experience the full success of your life is to go get some shock, some spinach, and cook it up and offer it to Krishna and take it as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's prasadam, and this will be the perfection of your life. Bhakati vinod Krishna bhajane anukulpai jaha proti divase paramasuke shikhar koraye taha. Bhaktivinoda concludes by saying, whosoever attains the stage of enthusiasm for these devotional practices, whosoever, I'm guessing it refers to jaha. And enthusiasm is probably translating anukul in this case. Anukul pai. Pai jaha. Whoever attains will be supremely blissful wherever he may be. Proti dibase means every day. Paramasuke, highest joy, svikar koraye taha. Accepting, svikar koro. Means the doing of accepting. So the whole idea of the song is to give some details of how we in our everyday lives can engage in favorable devotional service. So from what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, it's not so difficult. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakura ki jai. Sharanagati songs ki jai. Hare Krishna. Okay, so today we're coming close to the end of the month of Kartik, even though it just started 3 or 4 days ago, it seems like. And some of you have been doing special vratas. Some of you have been chanting 16 rounds in one go and finding it very blissful. I'm also finding it very blissful to chant 16 rounds in one go. Some of you during these last 5 days, I think today is the second to the last, is that right? Is tomorrow the last day or Monday the last day? I don't know.
In our calendar, Monday is the last day.
Okay. So second to last, set third to last day, whatever. Some are doing some special Bhishma Panchaka Vratas. Some of us are doing a mild Vrata of avoiding grains for 5 days, which I find very, very nice. It's very, not a big austerity, but it's definitely very nice. And so we'll see if time allows. We may discuss some more Damodar Leela today. But as I said, we do have a surprise guest. And we have some showings and tellings, I believe. Are we ready for some showings and tellings? We have a show and sing, I know, coming up.
Guru Maharaj, apologize. Mataji Jalangi has a, just a short show related to the song. So
okay. If
we show first, because it's yes. Related to the song we sang.
Yes, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj. Please accept my humble obeisances to Prabhupada. My obeisances to all the devotees. I would like to share my screen. I hope it will function. I prepared it some months ago already, so maybe some devotees know it. So, is it on the screen?
Not yet.
I don't know what should I do to share it.
Okay.
You can share the screen only from the laptop. You cannot share the screen from your mobile device. You can share only from the laptop.
Then I'm really sorry. I invite you to my Facebook site. Yes. Uh-huh. you can see it there.
Or okay.
Yes, if someone could open my Facebook site then and share the screen now, then it would function.
Uh-huh. Dharma Gupta, you want to try that?
I can try, Guru Maharaj. Just need to know the Mataji Jalangi's details because I'm not sure.
I guess it's just Jalangi. I don't know.
No, it's Ioana Marinianu Jalangi Dasi in.
Oh. Should we?
Maybe we can proceed. Yeah.
Should we meanwhile do have another?
Yes, that will be better. Until I prepare everything, so maybe devotees from Beijing can share.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So from Beijing, Prema Sarovara, you can turn on your microphone. There.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Beijing Yatra Ki Jai.
Jai.
Hare Krishna.
Dear Guru Maharaj, dear God brothers and sisters, greetings from Beijing. Please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. All glory to Sri Gurudev.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Last Saturday, Gurudev asked me to say something about the book projection and new cover of Gita book. Very glad to do this small service, and I hope Gurudev and God's siblings can understand my English.
Yes.
actually, Gita book is not the first book of Gurudev published in China. In December 2018, translation Krishna Seva is published by Yunnan University Press. I think a lot of my God brothers and sisters have seen this book in English. Yes, Gurudev?
Yes,
it
I think published. So. Yeah.
Yes. About this Chinese translation, I think every God siblings in Beijing and Hong Kong has one copy in their hand. we have 1,000 copies in the beginning, and we distributed about 520 copies now.
Oh, very good.
Oh, and we got about 28,000 RMB.
Oh, okay.
So, Gurumar, you see, we made an advancement slowly, but we'll try our best. And Gita book is the second book which Guru Maharaj wanted to publish in China. Its full title is Advancing, the Great River, Reflection on Yoga Philosophy and the Cross Culture Comparisons. Sorry.
Can you tell us what the title of the book is in Putonghua?
Oh, okay.
涉月大专, 瑜伽哲学反思与跨文化比较研究.
Very nice.
It's a little bit long.
No, it sounds nice.
Okay. Actually, it's an introduction to Bhagavad Gita, which consists of 5 chapters. In chapter 1, Guru Maharaj elaborated the 18 yogas in Bhagavad Gita. Then in the following 4 chapters, Guru Maharaj made comparative study between Gita and the other thought traditions in the world, like Christianity, Chan Buddhism, Yi Jing, and modern religious experience. It's an amazing book. Chinese scholars never did such research work like Guru Maharaj did in this book, I think.
You're biased.
Yes, that's a fact. Yes, Gurudev. Now let's take a look at the new cover. We can see the main colors are yellow and green. Guru Maharaj said he very much like yellow and green. It looks fresh.
Yeah.
In China, you know, I think also in India, yellow is a noble color. Mm. In ancient China, yellow is the color which is only used by emperor.
Yes.
And and Lord Krishna is the supreme emperor, supreme
yes.
lord.
Yes.
That we choose yellow for the book cover.
Yes.
Then why green is used here? Because the book's main title is Advancing Across the Great River. And the designer used the green to represent the river color.
Yeah.
Here we can see there are 2 kinds of green, dark green and light green. Why 2 greens here? Why 2 greens? And we can also see there are 2 kinds of oranges, light orange and dark orange. Why? What do they represent? We can see also several lines and several sparks or something like small signs where lines intersect. Gurudev, can you understand?
Yeah. Well, okay. As I understand, it's to represent a flowing river.
Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. So if you, but there are also some lines and sparks. So if you connect the lines, sparks, colors with the title Advancing Across the Great River, I believe you will understand they represent different rivers of different culture traditions in the world.
Very good. Okay.
Among all these traditions, Krishna is the focus and also the common element. So you can see Krishna Arjuna is in the middle of the rivers, which also gives us a message that if we follow Lord Krishna's instruction, just as Arjuna did, we can advance across the great river of birth and death without doubt.
Yes.
And also a tiny adjustment was made for the new cover. Now let's look at the old cover.
Oh.
The old cover. We can see there's a seat. There's a seat. There's a seat to support Krishna Arjuna's chariot and the horses originally. Later, Guru Maharaj suggested the seat should be removed in order to give the reader an expression of advancing across the river. It's a good idea, Gurudev. Now it looks much nicer, what do you think? Without the seat. Yeah.
Yes.
And yet we still have some more work to do. Firstly, regarding the small icon, icon, icon of Krishna.
Yeah.
Yesterday, Mr. Wan, the editor from Yunnan University Press, he said he's not very satisfied with the small icon. Originally, he asked the designer to draw a sketch. He would like the effect of Q colorless.
Okay.
Namely, the shadow of Krishna. Shadow.
Oh, I
but
see.
No,
more like,
but not
like
shadow,
silhouette. Yes. Like a silhouette, maybe. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, that's
now,
okay.
Okay. Mr. Van suggested he and we will search online and see what we can find. The better one.
Okay, that's good. I should mention to everyone else who is Mr. Wan. He is our editor from this press, Yunnan University Press, and he's been amazingly enthusiastic to publish these books, despite the obstacles, especially the government, as you may know, Chinese government is not very enthusiastic about religion. And
yes,
so in order to publish such a book, you need to get permissions from a special office of the government. And
yes.
Mr. Wan said, if we get permission for this book, he said, it will be a miracle.
Yes.
And so the miracle happened.
Yes.
Thank you so much. And I think we'll stop there because I'm noticing now how quickly the time is going and our
yes.
guest is going to be waiting. And I just wanted to say also Prema Sarovara has been translating this book into Mandarin language from English. So we're very grateful for that. Okay. Beijing Yatra Ki Jai. Now, I'm starting to get a little anxious, not in a negative way, but in a positive way, because at 2 o'clock we want to welcome our guest. And we also wanted before that to have Shyameshwari Sakhi and her family sing the Damodarastakam because this is coming to the end of the month of Damodar. So I think with apologies to Jalungi and Anandamayi, were you also going to do something?
Hare Krishna. I can do it the next meeting. It's
okay,
not a problem.
Yeah, that's good. Okay.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Okay. Shyameshwari Sakhi and Alokika Prema.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, everybody.
Pula, not Pula. What is it? Anyway, Istriya Yatra Ki Jai.
Yeah.
Can everyone hear?
Yes, we can hear.
Okay.
Thank you. Bravo. So nice.
Thank you.
It's a modest version.
The modest.
Modest
version. Huh?
Modest and calm version.
Yeah, no, it's very nice. I think it's a it was a good way to prepare us for the end of this month. So yes, please. For many of you don't know, this is a very musical family. Alokika Prema and his wife Aradhana. I saw Aradhana separately at one point.
She's in another room.
Oh, she's.
We have two rooms.
you kept her out of it, huh?
No, we don't fit all together.
Yeah, I don't know. Because of the instruments, I don't know.
They're very big.
Okay. Anyway, so very nice. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol. Yes, Sitarani, I'm sorry, you also were going to tell us about your book, but let's see if there's time. It depends. I'm trying to find out whether our guest is here yet or not.
Not yet, Guru Maharaj.
Not yet?
Not yet.
Oh, okay. What shall we do? We don't know when he's going to arrive, so I guess we could continue with one or another of you who wanted to show. Is Chalangi still there?
Maybe Betty Mataji Sitarani, because that Facebook is still not working.
Oh, okay. So, Sitarani, do you want to show us your book?
Yeah, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj.
Hare Krishna, Hare Bol.
Hong
Yatra Ki Jai.
Jai, and all other godbrothers and sisters and devotees. I'm so nervous anyway, but I will try my best to speak shortly, okay?
You'll do fine.
Thank you. By Guru Maharaj Messi, I want to show my small yoga book. So can you hear? In
yes.
Chinese, it's translate in English is some kind of yoga against depression.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. and in
Putonghua?
Putonghua. This
is Cantonese. Okay, this is Guangdonghua. So how does it sound in Guangdonghua?
Oh, yu da kong yi wan.
Yu da kong.
Kong yi wan.
Kong.
Yi wan.
Yi wan. Yi wan.
Yes, depression.
Oh, it sounds like depression. Yi wan.
Yes.
Yi wan.
So, So inside the book, we have can you see? Little cow. Her name is, I call her is a little girl, Go. In Chinese, uh-huh. You call her Go Mui. Mui means girl. Go is cow. So her name uh-huh. is little girl, Go. It's a pin at the back.
Uh-huh. Oh,
so
nice.
We can pin on the bag or on the jacket. Yeah. It's a free
nice.
Gift of the bag. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, inside the book, so there is a story of this girl cow. So why she got the depression and finally she get rid of the depression.
Uh-huh.
And will be happy. Yeah. And inside the book, I have asked some, but I have to say my book is not an academic book at all, sorry.
No.
It's just a yoga book, but I mentioned Krishna so many times inside the book. Mm. Yeah, and also have the Hare Krishna mantra, and also every chakra, we are talking about the seven chakras.
Mm-hmm.
So every chakra, I will show the color. Yeah. Sorry. I will show the color for each chakra, and then and also one Bhagavad Gita verse for each chakra, a little bit related verses. So
that's something we have been doing in our Beijing yoga program.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
So that's inspiring from you. And also we have some QR code. Then you can scan it. Then there is a video to show you how to do this, for example, this Dhanasana.
Yeah, that's interesting. I've never seen that before.
Yeah, this is inspiring from one devotee in Hong Kong, Majunja Kumar Babu. He said it is quite interesting if at this barcode inside the book. Yeah. And so at the beginning, I invited so many scholars, I can say scholars, to help me to write the preface. One is you, Guru Maharaj, and Shravaniya Manaji. And a few professors in CUHK.
Oh, yeah. Very good. So you got
few
endorsements.
My students, yeah. And also Siddhadeha Prabhu. Yeah. So, but in China, I'm also arranging the Chinese version, and Mr. Wan is also help us to, to help me to do. Now it's almost, I think, within these few months, can finish.
Okay. Very good.
And I also invited. Do you remember Tony Wong?
Oh yes.
Yeah. I also invited him to write a short preface for us. For me to show in the Chinese version.
Yeah, very good.
So yeah, everything is something like that. And also, I have some recipe at the end because I will speak about something Ayurveda and what kind of food is good for the depression, what kind of food is not good for the depression. So I want to try to do some recipe. To make it more colorful. Then I have a small pack of spices to include in the book also.
Everything is there, complete kit.
Yeah, so that's why at the back we have some free gifts. Yeah.
Only thing missing is japa mala.
Oh yeah, but I mentioned in the book.
Yeah, that's good.
I mentioned. Yeah, and also mentioned Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's my small yoga book for now.
Very good. Very good.
Thank you, Guru Maharaj.
You did it. I think you did it very quickly also.
At the beginning, quite quick. But finally, when I passed to the release by the press company in Hong Kong, they said, no, too short, cannot. So after that, I spent a few months to add more contents. So finally, December, published at last year, December.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good.
Thank you.
So onwards and upwards.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol. Sitarani is herself a yoga teacher since how many years? Oops, she just
17 years.
17 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm so old, that's why.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Okay. So then, still we don't have our guest. I wonder what happened. He's maybe some misunderstanding about the time and the place.
I'm still not sure regarding the name because its name is not full, so I don't know. Someone who has joined with name A, would you be so kind to unmute?
A, this might be him. The mysterious A. Hare Krishna, anybody there? Hello, hello. Can you ask him or her again?
No, it's not. It's Alalanath Prabhu.
Oh, it's Alalanath. We can make him the special guest. Surprise. Oh, okay. In that case, let's just continue. We have some more. Yeah, there was Ananamayi, there was Jalangi, who wanted to present something, so I guess we could proceed. Dharmagupta, are you still with us?
I have some issues with the sound, so I don't know if everyone hear me or see me. I don't know if it's from our side or from your side, but the voice is breaking.
We can hear you.
Can you please repeat the questions because I haven't heard it?
I was just suggesting that since we don't have our guest yet, we could proceed with our continuing sharing show and tell. So I think there was Jalangi. Did you manage to find her?
I can't find the content she wanted to share. So I'm trying to communicate.
Okay. And Anandamayi, you wanted to show something.
Yeah, yes. Almost there.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, everyone. I wanted just to say something because we ended this Club 16 almost with this chanting in one go. And that was a nice experience. Thank you, Maharaj, for your support and Avdarya Chandrika for this nice arrangement. And all devotees, that was really good time for all of us, I think. I was thinking, because there came some point of concentration on the chanting, and I was thinking to say something about this, about focusing on chanting, slow down the mind and woke up the soul. And I wanted to use one song. So we have today's song time. I was working on the mind, giving some seminars, exercises. So this was my topic. And maybe I will present some introduction to meditation, maybe some, because actually japa is meditation. Maybe we will try some one exercise with this song. I don't know. Maybe we will try to sit comfortably, relax, and leave aside everything. Just stop the mind, stop the running of the mind, and focus and try to listen to the song for 5 minutes. Just give this time only to Krishna. And try to listen also the text of this song. I will make it a little louder. And try also not judge and not analyze. Just just listen and watch. So would you like to go to the vacations? To fly somewhere? So I will take you for one trip with Kala Prabhu. This is the song, little bit like hypnotherapeutic. And we will go to the island of Canary. There are 7 islands. And so please just, you know, we are in this lockdown, so it's good to have some spiritual vacations, I think. So there are also 3 levels of this meditation in this song. So please, if you can try to hear this, I will share this song if it will be working for me. But I don't know. It always disappears when I want to share. I don't know, Dharmagupta, can you tell me something?
You said when you share the screen, you select the screen you want to share of those offered on your desktop.
Yeah, but this film just disappears. Before, when I was trying on the Zoom, it was there, but now it disappeared, so I don't know.
So just once again, unshare, stop sharing and share again. So when you click start sharing, it will offer like a several different desktops, whichever you have on your laptop at the moment. So you can select the one you want to share.
Yeah, but this doesn't work. I don't know.
Put stop sharing and then share again.
Sorry. I was checking it, but my computer is now not responding. Okay.
I don't know. Yes, now you're sharing, but you're sharing just your Zoom screen, so you can maybe select another one.
What do you mean?
On that, whatever you want, the different tab, you want to share that Facebook or what?
Yes, Facebook, yeah.
Click on that tab, that's it.
Yeah, okay. So we are here, so please relax, sorry, not too stressful.
Just one more thing, on your share screen at the bottom, you need to share audio as well.
So what I should do now? Stop sharing again, yeah?
No. Maybe you can just start the video.
Okay.
And look, sorry, sound should be there.
Okay. So do you hear now this? There's the sound? No?
No.
Yeah. Because that was the point.
Mm-hmm. At the bottom of your share screen, you have a small icon which is said share with sound at the bottom of your share screen. Okay. Of the frame you are sharing. Okay. Of the
so
window.
You want computer share or what? Computer? No.
You see left bottom corner. Left bottom corner, you see share computer sound at the left bottom corner.
Yeah.
You see the small box, you have to click the tick that box.
Yeah, okay, we'll try again. There's sound?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So we put the So have a nice vacations, Haribo. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare.
Color of a blue lotus flower or sapphire, sweeter than the sweet city of attractive attire. Where's my solar show? This is my only supplier. Smile like the moonlight, yes, bright blazing. The gopis' happiness constantly generated. Yellow garments, flower garlands decorated. There is a stumble in my step, it seems I'm medicated. Floating like a satellite, but so grounded as we dance in the dead of the night. Eyes restless, but you never left my sight. You're just for me, this ecstasy is the green light. As I cruise, your effulgence is the street light. Not satiated, but yeah, I'm satisfied. The mountains on your pinky. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Now I don't wanna understand. I just want you to come and take my hand.
Thank you. So I don't know if this would be called hip hop style or rap or combination, but Kavi Chandra can tell us.
Yeah, new age Mahamantra.
What would you call this, Kavi Chandra?
He cannot speak.
Oh, he's on a different channel or something.
Yeah. Okay. Yes, he translates the Guru Maharaj, so that's why right. He switch.
Anyway, yeah. So all right.
Thank you for this meditation and vacations with you, Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Hare Krishna. It's interesting how there are so many different ways that musical styles are being taken up by devotees to glorify Krishna. I think this has been, in terms of cultural spread, Prabhupada speaks about the cultural, what did he say? We will conquer by cultural expansion, something like that. And it seems like it's been especially by music. From the quite early days, devotees were taking up their own talents of music making with their own styles, and they were singing the Maha Mantra and then so many other songs, and this is still going on very much today. It's interesting to see. Well, I don't know what happened. Our mystery guest has become a real mystery. I looked to see if he sent me an email. Maybe, you know, something happened so he couldn't come. But I haven't seen any message. So, and Jalungi sent me a message that she sent me a link, but I couldn't find it. I'm sorry. So that'll have to be something also for another time. So, well, let's discuss Damodar Leela, shall we?
Yeah.
And shall we go back to Srimad Bhagavatam? Over the weeks, I've been going very slowly into Damodar Leela, and finally, I've come to, you can say, the opening scene, the main Leela, and it starts with chapter 9 of Srimad Bhagavatam, canto 10, with the very first and second verses, which go like this. Srila Shukadev Goswami tells us. Shri Shuka Uvacha, Ekada Grihadasishu, Yashoda Nandagehini, Karman Tarani Yuktasu, Nirmamanta Svayang Dadhi, Yani Yani Hagitani Tatbala Charitani Cha, Dadhi Nirmantane Kale Smaranti Tanya Gayata. And the translation slowly. Shri Shukadeva Goswami continued, one day, Ekada, one day when Mother Yashoda saw that all the maidservants were engaged in other household affairs, she personally began to churn the yogurt. While churning, she remembered the childish activities of Krishna. And in her own way, she composed songs and enjoyed singing to herself about all these activities. Now, I want to refer to something in Srila Prabhupada's purport, but before that, something I noticed with the Sanskrit. And that is in the second verse, Yani Yani Hagitani Tatbala Charitani Cha. This kind of repetition of Ani Ani, Gitani, Yani Yani, and Charitani. It gives this feeling, the sense of the rhythm of the churning of the yogurt. And it also, of course, gives us the sense in which Mother Yashoda is singing, because it's the second line is specifically about her singing. Tatbala Charitani, the charita, the activities of Tatbala, of her son, of her young one, Gitani, she is singing. At the same time, or rather, Dadhi Nirmantane Kale, at the time of the churning. So while she's churning, she's singing these songs. Smaranti, and she's remembering. Tani, them. Agayata, she's chanting. So in the purport, I'll just summarize the first paragraph. Prabhupada is referring to Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, who's pointing out when this pastime happened. He's saying that it happened on the day of Diwali, of Deepavali. And I think that's interesting because we associate Diwali so much with Lord Rama. And we, of course, light all of the lamps. It's also associated with Bali Maharaj. But here it's mentioned, we should also especially be remembering little Krishna as Damodar on this day. Prabhupada goes on to mention, I think this is also from Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, that Mother Yashoda had special cows taking special grass from a special field, and she wanted to prepare yogurt and butter and ghee from those cows, from that grass, from that field, specifically because she was concerned that this is the problem, that Krishna is going to the neighbors because he does not like this ordinary milk. Doesn't like the ordinary milk he wants. Okay, so she's gonna now make this special. She's taking the special milk from the special cows and she's churning that into butter. So that's her, she has a definite purpose here. Okay, now in the next paragraph, Prabhupada says, and I will read, while churning the butter, Mother Yashoda was singing about the childhood activities of Krishna. It was formerly a custom that if one wanted to remember something constantly, he would transform it into poetry or have this done by a professional poet. It appears that Mother Yashoda did not want to forget Krishna's activities at any time. Therefore, she poeticized all of Krishna's childhood activities, such as the killing of Putana, Agasura, Shakatasura, and Trinavarta, and while churning the butter, she sang about these activities in poetic form. Now, here Prabhupada gives us an instruction. He says, this should be the practice of persons eager to remain Krishna conscious 24 hours a day. This incident shows how Krishna conscious Mother Yashoda was. To stay in Krishna consciousness, we should follow such persons. Now, what I find striking is the point, it doesn't mention that Mother Yashoda wrote down any poetry, but what's suggested by Srila Prabhupada is that this is something that can be done, to write poetry describing Krishna's pastimes. And The practical reason why this is done is mentioned, and this is something that is commonly recognized by scholars of literature, that that oral literature, the sort of original form of literature, is oral, and it's in poetic form because it's easier to remember. And you may have this experience also. I have this I can more easily remember a shloka in Sanskrit from Bhagavad Gita than I can remember Srila Prabhupada's English translation. Because, I don't know, it's poetry, and it's somehow more memorizable. Yeah, so write about Krishna's pastimes and then chant what you write. That's something you can try in whatever language you like. Okay, now the next verse is in a very different meter. And one day I'm going to find out the name of this meter, but for now we'll just chant it. Kshomang vasa pritukatitate bibrati sutranadham putrasnehasnutakucha yugam jatakam panchasubru rajvakarsha shramabuja chalat kankanao kundalecha svinnang vaktrang kabaravigalan malati nirmamanta. This verse is describing Mother Yashoda as she is churning the butter, and then it tells about her decision. Is it, or is the next verse? No, it's the next verse where she makes a very troublesome decision. Okay, dressed in a saffron yellow sari, with a belt tied about her full hips, Mother Yashoda pulled on the churning rope, laboring considerably, her bangles and earrings moving and vibrating, and her whole body shaking. Because of her intense love for her child, her breasts were wet with milk. Her face, with its very beautiful eyebrows, was wet with perspiration, and malati flowers were falling from her hair. So this gives us a whole vision for meditation. We can meditate on, we can picture the scene that Mother Yashoda, up to now she's by herself, she's churning the butter, and we know she's singing, and she's working very hard. She's pulling the rope back and forth, and it's causing the bangles and her earrings to shake, and they're vibrating, and her body is shaking. And what else is happening? Because she is thinking of her baby, Krishna, her little boy. I think he's a toddler now. He's able to walk by himself, and he's able to make all the trouble that he's going to make very soon. So he's, 2 years old maybe now? because of her intense love for her child, her breasts are wet with milk. And speaking of wetness, her whole face is also wet with perspiration. And then on top of all of this, the flowers that are in her hair are falling down because of all of this effort. So a lot of things are going on. There's some real, we can say, some real industry happening here. Some butter production program is going on. Some very serious business, we may say. So serious that Mother Yashoda is perspiring. She's really working at this. Srila Prabhupada gives us some more very good advice in his purport to this verse. First, he says that anyone, and this is interesting, he's being inclusive here. Anyone who desires to be Krishna conscious in motherly affection or parental affection should contemplate the bodily features of Mother Yashoda. I find that interesting because there's always some discussion about how do we realize our spiritual identity, our eternal rasa with Krishna. And in this purport, Prabhupada seems to be suggesting that it's a matter of one's own inclination. Anyone who desires to be Krishna conscious in motherly affection, you want to be having this same mood as Mother Yashoda, then contemplate Mother Yashoda. But then, Prabhupada says, it is not that one should desire to become like Yashoda, for this is Mayavada. Then he goes on to say, whatever the rasa, whether it's conjugal or friendship or servitorship in any way, we must follow in the footsteps of the residents of Vrindavan, not try to become like them. So we follow, we don't imitate, and of course we don't want to become them because those positions are already taken. Mother Yashoda, we can't become Mother Yashoda because that position is already taken by Mother Yashoda. Advanced devotees must cherish this description, always thinking of Mother Yashoda's features. So we may think, well, I'm not an advanced devotee. Okay, but we can aspire to be advanced devotees, and that means we can practice. And so we can, one practice is to remember such a picture as this, how she was working and perspiring, how beautiful the flowers were arranged in her hair, and so on. And then again, Prabhupada gives specific advice. One should take advantage of the full description provided here by thinking of Mother Yashoda in maternal affection for Krishna. So that's practice. It's possible practice. Okay, let's take the next verse. We go back to Anushtup form. tam stanya kama asadya matnanting jananing hari grihitva dadhi mantanam nyasedhat pritim avahan. So Hari, Grihitva. While Mother Yashoda was churning butter, Lord Krishna, desiring to drink the milk of her breast, appeared before her, and in order to increase her transcendental pleasure, he caught hold of the churning rod and began to prevent her from churning. So pritim, in order to pritim avaha, to invoke a situation of love and affection. So Krishna has intentions, and what is his main intention? His core intention is to increase the love of his devotees and to experience their love and to share his love with them. And of course, here, little Krishna knows how to do this very quickly. So when he comes, we can again picture what he's doing, as a small child would do, just come and maybe grab the stick of the churning rod. And in the purport, Prabhupada says very briefly, Krishna was sleeping within the room, and as soon as he got up, he became hungry and went to his mother, wanting to stop her from churning and drink the milk of her breast. He stopped her from moving the churning rod. Now you may say, oh, but he's a very small child. A small child won't be strong enough to stop the churning of the mother, who is so much stronger than him. But, of course, who is Krishna? Krishna is the all-powerful Lord. So if he wants to, with one hand, even he's 2 years old, he can just grab and stop it. Or we can, of course, take it that Mother Yashoda understands, oh, he wants me to stop. So as mothers will know what the gesture means. Oh, he wants to drink my breast milk. Okay. And so she stops. Dira Lalita is asking, can one contemplate being a child in Krishna Leela? Yeah, that's an interesting question. What's your answer to that, Dira Lalita?
I don't have an answer. I was just thinking, you know, but I don't know if that can be compared. As devotees, we, let's say, we practice Krishna consciousness for all our lives, and then many devotees, they accomplish so much in their devotional service, some visible accomplishment. And there are those who don't. So I don't know how is that connected, but I was thinking that being a child is the best. You don't have responsibilities as such. you don't have to get stressed out. You're just sort of casual. You're just a child being like looked after, and like I don't know. I mean, I was this was also this just came out as a non-planned question.
Okay.
So I just wanted to ask you, Guru Maharaj, is that like contemplating? I mean, not fantasizing, but desiring.
Hmm.
Is that something that's normal or?
I don't know. Normal. Iris also just wrote Iris and said totally dependent. Yeah. So that's of course the essential mood for being as a child in Krishna Leela. Two things come to mind for me is one, we understand Vatsalya Rasa has to do with, we generally understand it means being the parent or being like a parent for Krishna who is acting helpless. But it can also be the other way around. One can also have Vatsalya Rasa with Krishna as the parent, as the father, as the protector, and one is the helpless child. And the other thing I was thinking is you were mentioning people accomplishing so much. Some devotees seem to accomplish so much, others maybe not. So within that observation, there's a tension of wondering about expectation. And yeah. There's, of course, two kinds of expectation. There's our expectations from ourselves, and there's expectation from others. And it's interesting to think of what you're suggesting is from a child, we don't really expect anything because they're just busy making trouble.
Yes.
Sugopi, you wanted to say something.
Thank you, Guru Maharaj.
Yes, Maharaj, I just wanted to say that because we being devotees are always aspiring to serve Krishna. So I think that if we are a child, we are taking service, like instead of giving service. So that's why these divisions, like, of course, there's again, Sakya Raksas is there where Krishna's friends, they are also children playing. But they are again serving. So because we are in a service mood, we want to serve Krishna instead of we being served. So that's why probably it's not mentioned that if we are in the mood of a child, like if we are like Krishna, small baby Krishna. So only these five categories probably, not the child one.
Mm. Okay, thank you. Yeah, I vaguely remember it's some time ago, but I'm reasonably sure Prabhupada mentions in the seventh canto in a purport that Vatsalya Rasa can be either in the mood of a parent or in the mood of a child. And he's speaking in connection, of course, with Prahlad. So Prahlad is the child who is then being protected by Nrsingadev. And yes, and then of course the question could come up. Isn't that a position of being served? But of course, with Prahlad, he was serving Krishna all the time, or Vishnu, or how was he serving? He was serving by remembering.
Guru Maharaj, if I could add something. And that why did I have a question is that I found, especially when a person is getting older, his body is getting older, and all the of services that we do by meditation in the heart and in the mind sometimes becomes stressful to accomplish all these external services that one does with the body. And sometimes a person, I mean me, I do get stressed out. And then I was thinking, you know, by being a child, it's more natural way of exchanging the love with Krishna. And not necessarily being helpless, but exchanging that a childish how would I say that expressions that only exists on that level. As soon as one is an adult person, that sort of level disappears, and everybody becomes like very serious adult. I mean, I work with children most of the time, so I could understand their worries a lot, because most of the time they actually don't understand the world of adults. So in my personal case, that it would be wonderful to be a child in Krishna's world, I think.
I'm sure it is. I think there's no disagreement there. And Madana Jeevani wants to make just such a point. Do you want to speak, Madana Jeevani?
Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj and everyone. I was just thinking that perhaps being a child in the spiritual world as a gopa, friend of Krishna, with whom Krishna can play and perform all his leelas and, you know, have a lot of fun is a service. Being a child is a service to Krishna. And also the little gopis in Vrindavan, all that, I was thinking that enhances Krishna's playful pastimes, and that can be seen as a service. Is it, Guru Maharaj? Mm. Is it so?
Why not? Of course, Krishna's friends are in a relationship of Sakya Rasa. And yes, their service is, you can say, to have fun with Krishna. To have fun. And part of the fun is what we discussed last time, is to make so-called trouble for Krishna when they report to Mother Yashoda that Krishna has eaten dirt. So in so many different ways, they will have fun with Krishna. And all of that is service. Even when they're making trouble for Krishna, that's also service. Now, I have a... Chitrakarani is also... Are you there? Do you want to ask... do you want to speak, Chitrakarani? Is she here?
Hare Krishna, please accept my respect.
Hare Krishna, Jai.
Hare Krishna. The question is, if the place of Mother Yashoda is taken, what can other millions of devotees do who are in the same Vatsalya Rasa?
If the place is already taken, if Krishna's mother is already Krishna's mother, how can I be Krishna's mother, right?
Yes.
I'll let you know when I get there to Goloka Vrindavan. I don't know how that works. But my understanding is there's no limitations in Goloka Vrindavan. Everyone can serve in exactly the place where everyone wants to be. And that place, well, we always hear that everyone wants to be the servant of the servant. So the gopis, there are the principal gopis, and then there are the manjaris, and then they have everyone has their assistants and then the assistant's assistants, and everybody is happy in those positions. So Mother Yashoda has her assistants who would presumably have a similar mood in relation to Krishna. That's my understanding.
Thank you, Guru Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. Now, here's a question for you to contemplate over the next week, and we can discuss it next week. And first, I want to apologize. I got everyone's hopes up. My hopes were up as well for our mystery guest, and then he didn't appear. And who knows what? Something may have come up that I can say it's he, not she this time, which was unexpected. So that happens. We will have him another time. Here's something you can think about.
Maharaj, am I by chance the mystery guest you were discussing, or I just sit quietly and...
Have you been here all along?
I just joined at 8:59. I was told this session began at 9 a.m., so according to my calendar, I'm 1 minute short. Well, I'm 1 minute early.
Oh. Oh, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Welcome, Anuttama Prabhu. Panchakalpatrup yascha kripasindu vyeva cha bhaktitanam bhavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo nama.
I'm worried.
Okay, this was my fault.
Was there a translation in the time that was wrong? Am I an hour late?
I made the time wrong. It's all my fault. I was thinking I was thinking there's a 5-hour difference when there's a 6-hour difference. I guess that's the mistake. Because now is the time when we end our session. But now you all know who is the mystery guest. Anuttama Prabhu, some of you don't know him, he's a wonderful devotee. He is, I'll say like this, because everyone now knows your good wife. So I will say Anuttama is the husband of Rukmini Devi. And so many other things. He is the minister of the communications ministry. He is therefore a member of the GBC. He is active in so many areas of, I would say, the public sphere around ISKCON. And I'm thinking now, I was going to give you a more of an introduction than that, but because of the time and my mistake, for which I'm apologizing to all of you, and especially you, Anuttama Prabhu, can we do a rain check on this so that we'll have a full time with you?
Sure. We just have to schedule some other week.
Yeah. How are you for next week?
Next week.
Are you busy with the AAR conference like I am?
No, I skipped that this year. We had the men's retreat, I think, that same weekend.
Okay.
But, yeah, no. Let's see. So next week would be December the 5th, right?
December 5th, right.
Yeah, and it would be at 8 o'clock?
It must be 8 o'clock,
yes. An hour earlier, right?
Yes, an hour earlier.
Okay, so I'll try to change my identity sometime during the week so it'll be a surprise.
Okay, we'll give you a week to figure out how to surprise us.
Okay. So next week, same day as today, 1 week from today, but 1 hour earlier, correct?
That's right. That's it.
Okay, sure.
And yeah. And I can say now, I can say to all of us online, all of the others of you, you can be thinking, we wanted to talk about, because Anuttama Prabhu is a highly seasoned, experienced devotee in interreligious dialogue, that you may have questions for him. But I would say also you may have some question with respect to anything related to the International Society for Krishna Consciousness. How's that? Anything related to the public side of ISKCON, perhaps. Anuttama Prabhu, I know as a wonderfully thoughtful devotee. A thoughtful and inspiring by his thoughtfulness devotee. So we're going to have the benefit of his association next week. I would just, stretch for another hour now, but everyone has their schedules, so I won't do that.
Yeah, this is a big group, so it would be hard to. But next week works fine for me, Maharaj.
Okay, and, you're very kind.
Maybe it's all Krishna's plan, because I can go back and read another article I'm supposed to have done for the Gaudiya Studies group in an hour from now. I will be a better student by your grace of giving me an extra hour to study my...
Okay. Hare Krishna. Okay. Looking forward to seeing you next week.
And so same link, same code and all of that, Maharaj, I'll just transfer that forward?
I think it'll be a different link, Dharmagupta.
Yes, Maharaj, it will be a different link. Anuttama Prabhu, I will send you a new link for next Saturday's meeting.
Okay. And Prabhu, just make sure you get a response back from me saying, yes, I have it. And if you didn't get that link, feel free to... nag me, harass me until you get a confirmation.
Okay.
And well, then I'll sign off and I'll join you next week.
Yes, thank you. Hare Krishna.
Okay, I look forward to being with everyone. I see a lot of very special Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis and old friends, new friends, and so I'll be back next week then. Thank you.
Okay. And I will say thank all of you for being with us today, and have a wonderful rest of Kartik through Monday, and Bhishma Panchaka, and the rest of next week. And yes, I want to request prayers. I don't know if I should say this. For myself, this coming Wednesday, I have a short presentation in an academic conference. It's the American Academy of Religion. This is actually a huge conference in America that goes on every year. Thousands of professors, scholars of religion take part. I'm going to be in one panel speaking about the Bhagavatam. And because it's kind of hardcore scholars, so I'm a little bit nervous. But with your good wishes, it may go okay.
Cool.
So, Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Ananta Koti Vaishnavinda ki jai, Gaur Premanande Hari Hare
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Bol.
Hare Bol.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.